Good morning out there, Lombard staff and students. It's Wellness Wednesday. It is Secretary's Day, and we are heading to the Orpheum, both 5th and 6th grade. So schedules are a little unique today, and I do appreciate our staff and our students for understanding and being flexible. It's always a great opportunity when we can take a little break from the school setting and head to different places. But again, it is a privilege, so we hope that we do not have to contact any families to come pick up students there, or for you to receive a consequence that you would have to serve later on, which could impact your future field trips and some other things that we have planned that are very exciting in May. So I hope that our students can understand. If you are someone who doesn't enjoy this type of stuff, remember, you're not doing math work, you're not doing homework. You are, again, getting to just take a little break and visit the Orpheum, which is a beautiful theater. And so I hope everyone has a great day today. I'll be with all of you there. And I hope that I can enjoy it too, and we don't have to be worried about student behaviors. For Wellness Wednesday today, we are going to again watch a quick video that I think is very powerful because I really feel it connects to our focus on kindness and also just the understanding, because when we are educated about different topics such as autism, it can help us again create a better school environment, a better community, and can help us help others. And so I hope that you can sit back, stop being on your computer right now, and really watch this, because I will tell you, most of the time I am so amazed and impressed with our student body. But there are some situations that are starting to come through to my email, whether it be screenshots of different Snapchat chats that are occurring or different memes that are being sent. And it is heartbreaking. Staff, I'm going to tell you right now, I think we all need to be thankful that we aren't living in the middle school times right now, because the unkind words, images, things that some of us are thinking that we have the right to do just really breaks my heart. And these are individuals that can't then get away from it. You are, again, being behind a screen. And I want to tell all of you, if you really think you're brave behind a screen, you are not. And to me, I feel that if you are a student that is receiving those things, do everything you can to avoid those chats. Because like I said, those are never brave people that are behind a screen and sending those things to hurt you. So I hope this video not only inspires us to learn about autism, but also learn about how our words and actions can actually help people. And that's what we want to do in this world today. Like I said, I am just heartbroken that there are young students that want to hurt others. But please make sure that if you are someone that is being hurt by others, please find ways to shine your light. This is a great week to really embrace, okay, the power of being different and how important it is for you to be you. And the staff here, we're adults. We've lived through some of these difficult times. But we want all of you to know that we see your uniqueness, and we absolutely, every single day, are just amazed by the resilience and also, again, the gifts and talents each of you bring to Lombard Middle School. So let's sit back, let's watch this video, and then have a great discussion about how kindness connects with this Spirit Week.
We are all different, and that's wonderful. Some differences are easy to see. Height, hairstyle, gender, eye color, and so on. Other differences can't be seen. Our favorite foods, fears, or special skills. Interestingly, the way we see the world is also different. For instance, what do you see in this drawing? Most people see a duck, but some of you might have seen a rabbit. Whichever you saw, you are correct. This is just a trick drawing to show you that all brains work differently. The brain is your body's computer. It works differently for all of us and controls how you learn. That's why we are all good at different things. How you feel, which is why we all feel different emotions. And how you communicate. Sometimes the brain is connected in such a way it affects the senses and how we perceive and read situations and interactions. This is known as autism. Many people have autism, so it's likely you already know someone who is autistic. And for this reason, it's useful to know a little bit about autism. The special wiring inside an autistic brain can sometimes make the person good at tasks we may find difficult, such as mathematics, drawing, or music. It can also do the opposite, and activities we find too easy are incredibly difficult to them, such as making friends. The senses constantly send information to your brain about your surroundings and other people. However, when a person's brain and its senses don't communicate well, the brain can become overwhelmed and confused, affecting how they see the world. Picture yourself walking down the street. This is how an autistic brain may experience the same world. Scary, isn't it? Sadly, in many cases, the person can't say out loud how they feel. So even though there's chaos going on in their heads, they seem okay on the outside, unable to ask for help. We will develop behaviors to help us feel calm in uncomfortable situations. We may look away, hug ourselves, chew our fingernails, fidget, bite our lips, and so on. Equally, autistic people develop behaviors that help them cope with these intense moments. These actions may seem unusual, but they're just their way to feel calm. When they happen, it means they are having a hard time. The kind thing to do is not to give them an even harder time by getting cross, ignoring them, or mocking them. People with autism need friends who are willing to take the time to know them. With good communication and plenty of patience, everyone would be better off. People with autism are not ill or broken. They simply have a unique view of the world. And with a little support from their friends, they might just be able to share that view with us. Autism can make amazing things happen.
Thanks for watching that video. I would love to hear a student body discussion on just the different actions that we can take to help Lombard. Again, make sure that we are spreading kindness here. And what can we reflect on individually? Because we all make mistakes, even as adults. But what can we do to make sure that we're not hurting one another, but we're building each other up? How can we encourage one another? How can we help others, again, have more friends here? What can we do when we see someone sitting alone? I would love to hear those ideas, because students, you can be the change, and it's your future that we're worried about. I hope everyone, again, enjoyed that video, and I hope it did encourage some reflection with our student body. And now let's celebrate some Lombard birthdays.
Happy birthday, happy, happy birthday. We celebrate your life today. We're glad that you were born today. What we don't mean today, you know what we mean, eh? Happy birthday, happy, happy birthday. We celebrate your life today. We're glad that you were born today. What we don't mean today, you know what we mean, eh?
And we hope you have a wonderful birthday. I can't forget, we got to get our spinning wheel out to see who the riddle winner was. We had lots of entries for this one. Again, the taxi driver was walking. Again, the word was everything. So it's a G that was at the end. And then M was the third answer. So let's take a look and see which class, because there's a lot of homerooms on this wheel. Congratulations, and you will receive your prize on Friday. And now let's hear what's on the lunch menu for today.
I think it's time to get some
lunch, lunch, it's time for lunch, lunch, it's time to munch, crunch, eat a bunch, it's time for lunch, not brunch.
That is it for today. We'll just end again with another quote. Just to, again, I think I talked about this earlier, but don't be afraid to be different. be afraid to be the same. And again, let's really embrace and celebrate our differences. I hope everyone again enjoys their time at the Orpheum. Please make sure you understand you are representing Lombard Middle School and District 205. I hope everyone has a wonderful Wednesday. As always, Zephyrs, go be great.
Today is a new day, a day I promise to work hard, be kind, show pride, and celebrate who I am. We are Lombard!